Alright, so welcome to How to Dino, and in this video I'd like to cover a bit of an underrated feature, that is weblogs. To get started, let's head over to our server dashboard. So we'll start by clicking on the Manage Servers button, select the server we'd like to manage, and off to the left here we have logs, so we'll click on that, and here we can see our dashboard log. So any action that is performed within the dashboard is logged, and you can come over to this section to view all the actions performed on the dashboard. This is a great way to stay on top of things and to monitor who changes what. With this, we can see the date and time of the action, the user who performed the action, so the user ID, along with the username and the action performed. I'd also like to point out that if we go to our dashboard home, we can actually see recent activity performed within the dashboard. Let's head over back to dashboard logs. And here at the top, we've got three other tabs. We've got logs for our moderation, auto mod, and commands in general. Now, these three tabs are actually similar to what we'd get in our server through mod logs and the action log, as well as just your standard auto mod logs as well. So these are all similar to what you'd receive in the server. The only difference is that you're getting it through the dashboard, and this might be a little bit more easier to sort through or even search through. So with this, we get similar information. We have the date and time, the case number, the action performed, the user the action was performed on, so the user ID and the username for that user, the moderator who performed the action, as well as the reason. For AutoMod, we get the date and time of when the action was performed. We get the username and user ID of the user who triggered AutoMod, the filter type they triggered, and the message that actually triggered AutoMod. Lastly, we have logs for every single command ran within our server. So whenever a user successfully runs a command, it should be sent to our command logs. Here we get the date and time, the user who performed the command that was used, and then the command along with the parameters that might have been used. So this is just a great way to keep track of things and stay on top of your server. I'd also like to point out that down here off to the bottom, we can expand how many rows we see. So right now we're seeing 20 rows, but we can go as high as 100 rows and see what has been performed. We also have buttons to go to the next page and to the previous page. I'd also like to point out that there is a section for warning logs as well. So users that have been warned in your server, logs will be generated here. So we get the date and time, the warning ID, the user who received the warning, and the moderator that performed the warn. So now that you guys know that this section actually exists, hopefully more people will utilize this section if they aren't already.
Thanks for watching. Remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe.